Hey, it's John, Enduring Charm. Something a little different this time. We're going to look at some water that has been coming in to this basement here. And I think I'll have video. I'm going to try to put it up if I do. Basically, during a heavy rainstorm, the homeowner sees water coming in here. And this is the gas pipe. And there's enough pressure where it just kind of spits out here and just runs down the wall. There is a sump pump in this area, which is good, but you know, if you have water coming in from the wall here, that's not good. So we're going to see if we can do something about this. Now, this is not an uncommon problem. Anytime you have a penetration through the block walls like this, there's a potential for water. You get hydrostatic pressure, which is basically the water building up on the outside of the wall, and that water has weight. As it sinks down, it creates pressure, and if it finds a place to come in, it's going to start pissing in there. So if you have a heavy rain, or if you have gutters that are poorly located or not draining off well, that sort of thing, the grade is wrong, you can have water coming in. But you can also have water coming in when it follows this pipe, because this pipe goes all the way out to the street, and anywhere along that way there could be water in the ground coming down. And when it finds maybe a little canal, basically, or a path along the side of this pipe, it can follow that pipe until it comes down here where the house is. So that's something we can probably fix, but we need to look outside. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to measure from a convenient point so we can go outside and dig down. Now, this is not that deep. If it was deeper, I might have different concern about this. But if I get my tape measure out here, there's a little window here, which is to allow the meter reader to read the meter. And I can use that as a reference point. I know the ground is not too much below that, so this pipe is located about 2 feet down, which is not terrible. We can dig that. And then over, I don't know, about 10 to 12 inches or so from that window. So that gives me an approximation where the pipe is, and we can go out and hand dig this. Now, I want to caution you, obviously we don't want to use machinery, we don't want to use picks or anything like that near this gas line. But if we dig carefully with a shovel by hand, we'll be okay. Now, while I'm on this subject, there was also some water coming in through some of these cracks right here. So this is where the slab meets the foundation wall here. Now, this foundation wall goes below the slab, and there's a footing under there. So it's not unusual for a very small crack to develop here. If it's not too bad, you can just kind of cut with a grinder and just cut away this area right here, and then use a silicone caulk or possibly a hydraulic cement to seal that up. And that may be enough, assuming it's not too bad. But you know, a sump pump or more than one sump pump is necessary to get that pressure of the water, you know, from underneath the slab. Because if that water's coming up, you know, no amount of sealing is gonna solve this problem here. You got to take away that pressure. All right, outside here, as I'm looking, we can see that's where that window is that we were just talking about. And I'm not sure if this comes across on camera, but there is a little dip in the grade here. So it comes along here and does dip down there, comes along here and also dips down. So I think that's probably where our pipe is, and if I measure over, that looks about right. So I'm going to dig this area out and see what we can find. Now, the reason that's dipped down there just could be that the recent storm that was here, which was quite severe, may have just washed away some of the dirt that was previously, you know, supporting that. So that could be part of the issue. I also notice here there is a crack in the foundation. Now, that's a vertical crack, which is less concerning than a horizontal crack. But, you know, and that could be related to this window as well. But there is some movement here. So I think if we dig this up, we can try to see what they did when they went through the foundation. Maybe there's some damage there we can repair. So let's dig it up and see what we find. So this is interesting. Even just after raking the mulch away, you can see there's quite a dip in this area right here. So the ground comes down, and that's right where the gas line is. So obviously that's a problem. You want pitch or the grade to be away from the house. And right now we have the opposite. It's going towards the house and there's a dip right where that pipe is. So after we dig this up, I think we're going to be able to fix this. As I'm getting deeper here, I just want to point something out. I must be getting very close. I might have to move a few inches one side or the other. But you see this little thing right here? That's a root, a tree root. It's about, I don't know, 1 1/4 inch thick. And that's also not an uncommon thing where, you know, if a nearby tree, and there is a Douglas fir that's not too far away, they tend to follow the water. So in this case, it found a place along the side of the foundation, and that tree root, as it gets bigger, it can cause all sorts of damage with the foundation. So that's something to watch as well. Now, I don't want to use a pick to cut that. I'll use a set of nippers and I'll cut both sides and I'll dig a little bit deeper. And we've got to be pretty close to that pipe now. All right, we've got the hole pretty well dug here. And you can see there's that green area right here. That's electrical tape, green electrical tape, basically. You can see, I hope, where it goes into the foundation there. When they did this originally, this is about 30 years old, I think. Basically, they just broke open, it looks like just with a sledgehammer, honestly. They didn't take too much trouble about it. It's not like they used a drill or anything like that. They just pounded through that block and, you know, threw the pipe through and then just filled it with some mortar or grout, I'm not sure what. So basically, that giant hole there is too big and it's leaking around the edges. What I can do about it now, I just sprayed some water in there. That's what that water is you see in the bottom. That's from a hose. The soil here is just hard clay. So what I can do is clean this up a little bit more, wash it down, and I can do a parge coat of like a non-shrink grout or a mortar. Honestly, it doesn't really matter that much. You see that black stuff right here, that's a tar coating on the foundation. So how well the mortar is going to stick to that, I don't know. And then when I backfill, there's some things I can do, like using sand or stone to provide some relief so that if water does get in this area, it's not clay pressing against the foundation. There's got some space there for water to kind of sink down and not go into the foundation. It relieves some of the pressure. So first thing I want to do is just clean this up a little bit better, and then we'll see about parging. All right, I have this, it's made by Rapid Set. It's called Cementol. It's just a repair material. It's mostly hydraulic cement with some aggregate in it, very fine aggregate, very fast setting. You could use other things, but it's basically a non-shrink grout is what it is. I'm also going to be adding what's called anti-hydro, right, which helps to waterproof the final product once it cures. So I'll mix it with this. And when I say parge coat, what I really mean is I'm just going to take a trowel like this and get a bunch of the mortar or grout onto that and just draw it along the edge or the surface of the wall and keep doing that until I get a nice, you know, smooth surface. And then I'll work it around that pipe to make sure it's nice and tight. Now, I'm not sure how much I'm going to be able to show you because it's very tight quarters in there. I'm not sure I can get a camera in there, but at least you have a general description of what I'm about to do. Thank you. All right, it's not the prettiest work I've ever done, but it's going to seal, I think. So I've gotten all that parging done, and right around the pipe itself, I got as tight as I could, but I'm not going to rely on that alone. So I'm going to let this cure, and that'll solve the big parts that were kind of open to the dirt there. But around the pipe itself, I'll use a silicone caulk to seal that for sure. And by sealing all of this on the outside, you're better off than trying to seal it on the inside, because the pressure is from the outside after all. Now, having said that, I probably will put a bead of caulk on the inside anyway, just belt and suspender kind of thing. But this is where the major work is getting done. So I need to let that set up and cure. Once it does, I'll caulk around that. I'll backfill around the pipe with rock or sand, just to give it some drainage there. And then I'll backfill with the dirt that came out of there. All right, I need to let this parge coat set up a little bit more, probably another couple hours, and that'll be dry enough or cured enough where I can backfill. And you know, I'll just use some crushed rock around the pipe anyway, so that there's no pressure on the pipe and that area of the foundation that was damaged. We'll get that situated, and then I'll backfill with all the dirt that I saved. Before I do that though, I will caulk around that pipe right where it enters, even though I was very careful about getting the grout tight against there, you know. Again, belt and suspender kind of thing. You can't be too sure. Now, there's not really a great way for me to test this in advance. I mean, I could put a hose on it and everything, but that's really not that much pressure. So really, we're gonna have to wait until there's another big storm to know if it was successful or not, but I have a pretty good feeling that it will be. So that's how you would handle this. If you have any kind of pipe, it could be a gas pipe like this, it could be a septic or a sewer pipe coming in. Same idea, you just want to dig around it, see if there's any damage with the foundation, repair what you can, and seal the outside and the inside for the heck of it. And that should take care of the problem.